Hello, welcome to our MOOC, Bio-based Products for Sustainable Bioeconomy. My name is Vincent Renke and I'm Program Director of Biotech Delft at TU Delft. In this introduction video to the MOOC, we will go to four experts of the bio-based economy using four transportation methods. And we will do some small calculations regarding these transportation methods to give you insight in what they are using in sense of energy consumption. I hope you enjoy. Today we will go to Patricia Ossewaier, who lives in Delft, and we will go by a fossil fuel car, a regular car. While we're driving, look at all those cars. Did you know that 20 to 40% of our total energy consumption goes into moving stuff around?
So I'm currently driving with my Nissan Almera, who drives 13 kilometers on 1 liter of gasoline. The distance we are covering today is 13 kilometers, and the emissions per liter of fuels is 2.31 kilograms CO2, which means today we put 2.31 kilograms of CO2 in the atmosphere.
I'm here at the Faculty of Applied Sciences at the TU Delft to talk to Patricia Ossewaier about the bio-based economy.
I am Patricia Ossewaier. I'm professor at the Delft University of Technology. I'm strongly motivated by the evidence that climate change is a real fast-growing problem. I'm convinced that biological resources and biotechnology can help in our challenge to replace fossil feedstocks for energy, for fuels, for materials and for chemicals. There is no silver bullet that will solve the warming Earth, or tackle food and water needs, or address social development for the poor. That means that we really need to see how different solutions can both contribute to this.
So I just talked to Patricia here at TU Delft, and I came here by fossil fuel car, and I'm really excited because now I can drive with this Tesla towards Wageningen. There I'm going to talk to Harry Bitter, who's an expert in bio-based chemistry and technology. And well, while we're driving towards him, we will check what's the differences between a fossil fuel car and an electric car, besides that it's awesome to drive in one. See you in Wageningen. So while we're driving, let's do some calculations.
The efficiency of this Tesla car is 0.22 kilowatt hours per kilometer. Per kilowatt hour, the Tesla puts in 0.479 kilograms of CO2 in the atmosphere. We are driving a total of 104 kilometers, which means this trip puts in 11 kilograms of CO2 in the atmosphere.
I think one of the strongest driving forces for a bioeconomy is, in short, sustainability, to keep our planet inhabitable. But keep in mind here, we use a lot of biomass and bio-based feedstocks, and they are not per se good. Everything we do has its pros and cons. And we need to make choices. And we need to make the right choices. And that is what is important also in understanding and studying a bio-based economy.
Today is a relaxing day for me, because we will go by train. And we will go to Wim Soutaert. And while we are waiting for the train, let's again do some calculations.
When we take the train, we have to take into account that in a train more than one passenger is moved. In this case, we took an average of 100 passengers per trip. The efficiency of a train per passenger per kilometer would be 0.042 kilowatt hours. The carbon intensity would be 0.485 kilograms of CH2 per kilowatt hours, taken that the energy is generated in Germany. Then the average emission would be 0.0204 kilograms of CO2 per passenger per kilometer. I had to travel a distance of 180 kilometers, which would bring this total trip to 3.7 kilograms of CO2.
Yeah, so I've always been very active in the development of the bioeconomy. So as a professor of industrial biotechnology, obviously I'm active in development of technology, but I have also set up the BioBase Euro pilot plant for scale-up and demonstration of the new technologies, and also in terms of lobbying and networking, I have initiated the Flanders Bio-based Valley.
I asked the MOOC board if I could take a helicopter to the next speaker, but they replied, take the bicycle or walk. So I decided to take a walk, because I think it's a nice baseline. So how would all the other means of transport compare to walking? So I have to walk for 420 kilometers. Wish me luck, see you there.
In this case, I took myself as a general human being of 68 kilograms and walking speed on average 4 kilometers per hour. In that case, I would be burning 52.6 kilocalories per kilometer, and the total distance I walked was 420 kilometers, which means I approximately burned 22,000 kilocalories. On average, we took that I burn glucose. If we burn 1 mole of glucose, we generate 670 kilocalories, which would mean that in the total trip, I burned 33 moles of glucose. In total, we have approximately 200 moles of CO2 in the air. Multiply that by the atomic weight of CO2, we come to the conclusion that I put 8.7 kilograms of CO2 in the atmosphere.
The limited oil resources, the oil price fluctuations, and the CO2 in the air brought us on the way to the bioeconomy. So, in most of parts of this world, we agree that climate change happens. This brought us to the Paris Climate Summit and to the declaration. And this is now a political driver for the development of the bioeconomy. And we would like to contribute.
So finally, while I'm walking back, let's review all calculations and see what conclusions we can draw from them. So I've summarized all calculations here. And using walking as a baseline, we can see that using the train is a little bit more efficient than walking itself. And driving, although it's way more convenient, emits up to 857% more CO2. But in this calculation, we took a very easy method and only checked energy consumptions of the means of transport we used. And is that fair? No. We did not take into account many other factors, like the efficiency of making the energy source, transporting the energy to the vehicle itself, building the vehicle, the lifespan of the vehicle, and so on. This easy calculation can be very deceiving. You actually have to do a full life cycle analysis on this, and even then, it has to be clear where you put your boundaries on the things that you take into account. And lucky you, you get to do this in the next units. Let me point out one more thing. As all the experts pointed out, we are on the right track, but there still has to be done a lot. And we need to do a global effort in order to reach the goals we want to reach. So reach out to your colleagues via the forum on this platform and discuss your ideas and inspire others. Together we can make a difference. Good luck and do your best in the MOOC.